With all of these mods, the 3.0 EcoBoost should end up somewhere in the ballpark of about 425 to 475 wheel horsepower. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on how to build a 450 plus wheel horsepower 3.0 EcoBoost. The 3-liter Ford EcoBoost engine originally made its debut in 2016, however, it was in a very limited number of models up until about 2020. And since the 2020s, the 3.0 EcoBoost is becoming a much more common and popular engine, being found in a number of different vehicles, including the Ford Bronco Raptor, as well as the Ford Ranger Raptor, and it also made its way into some other models like the Ford Explorer ST. Now, the 3-liter EcoBoost twin-turbo V6 engine delivers anywhere from 350 to 418 horsepower and 400 to 440 foot-pounds of torque from the factory, so already pretty impressive numbers for this 3-liter twin-turbocharged engine. However, thanks to that twin-turbo design, the 3.0 EcoBoost does leave a lot on the table from the factory, and it's very easy to pick up an additional 100 plus wheel horsepower with a few simple bolt-on modifications. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump into some of those best modifications to build a 450 plus wheel horsepower 3-liter EcoBoost. Starting off at number one on the list, we have tuning. Tuning is really the foundation to building a more powerful 3-liter EcoBoost engine, and really that boils down to turbocharged and forced induction engines offering incredible power gains by itself, but these tunes also help maximize and extract the full performance potential from additional modifications. So speaking of those incredible power gains that you can see from tuning alone, on the 3.0 EcoBoost with just a tune, you can see gains in the ballpark of about 50 to 100 wheel horsepower and roughly 70 to 120 wheel torque. So already incredible gains right there. Now, where that falls on the spectrum of exact power gains depends on what kind of stage tune you're running, how aggressive that tune is, and ultimately what fuel you are running. Nonetheless, these are still incredible gains for just a tune and nothing else done to the engine. Tuning options are a little bit limited. However, Livernoy Motorsports offers some excellent tunes for all of these 3.0 EcoBoost engines, and there are also some other great options out there, and surely more to come as these platforms and engines become more and more common. Moving on to the second best mod, we have an intake upgrade. Out of everything I'm discussing in this video, an intake is going to have some of the more underwhelming power gains. However, it's an incredibly cheap, simple, and effective upgrade. Ultimately, as you continue increasing the horsepower and boost, it becomes more and more important to get air into the engine. So that's where intake upgrades come into play. And it's really an excellent first modification to combine with a tune. Benefits of an intake, you should see gains of about 3 to 7 wheel horsepower, about 5 to 10 wheel torque, and they often produce a more noticeable induction and turbo spool sound. And again, overall, this is just a very cheap, simple, and ultimately effective modification for the 3.0 EcoBoost. Moving on to our third modification, we have downpipe upgrades. As you start increasing power and torque, you need to get air into the engine more efficiently, as well as get it out of the engine and through the turbochargers more efficiently. So that's where downpipes come into play, as they reduce back pressure in the downpipe and really help the engine move the air out of the cylinders, through the turbochargers, and ultimately out of the exhaust system. So with downpipes, you can expect to see gains of roughly 10 to 15 wheel horsepower and about 15 to 25 wheel torque. So very good power gains for a simple bolt-on modification like downpipes. In addition to that, as I mentioned, they reduce back pressure, which ultimately leads to faster turbo spool. It's also a lot safer and easier for the engine and turbo. So overall, it's a very good upgrade for engine health and longevity. And on top of that, the downpipes offer incredible power gains, so really if you're looking for another modification after tuning, downpipes would certainly be the next best bang for your buck modification. One final very brief topic when it comes to downpipes, there are high flow catted options as well as catless options. High flow catted downpipes are going to offer gains on the lower end, but will mostly remain emissions legal. Catless downpipes, on the other hand, will be emissions illegal, even in states where you don't have actual emissions testing. If they do a visual inspection of the car, they will see that there are no catalytic converters in place, and that will be an instant fail even if it doesn't fail the actual emissions testing. So that is a downside to catalyst downpipes. Are going to offer the biggest performance and power gains at the cost of being illegal and making it challenging to pass any form of emissions or visual inspections. Moving on to the fourth best upgrade, we have intercooler, or FMIC upgrades for short. Now the intercooler on the stock 3.0 EcoBoost is very efficient at the stock power and boost levels. However, once you start increasing that, you are going to have more heat and your intake air temperatures are going to start climbing. And that's where the stock intercooler really starts becoming inefficient. So upgrading that to a larger, more efficient intercooler will help keep those intake air temperatures in check and ultimately result in much more consistent and better performance overall. Now, if you go to the dyno and do a glory run on a cooler engine, you're probably not going to see any major peak power gains, if any at all. However, what this really boils down to is the intercooler in the long run, especially when you do back-to-back pulls or the engine really gets up to temperature, the intercooler is going to help keep those intake air temperatures down, and ultimately that's what's going to result in the very consistent performance. And so while you might not see peak gains after back-to-back runs, an intercooler can actually prevent you from losing horsepower due to heat soak. Hotter air is less dense and you're losing power there, and oftentimes if things get too hot, the engine will actually start backing out some boost and performance to keep it safe and prevent any knock or detonation events. Moving on to our fifth and final modification for building a 450 plus wheel horsepower 3-liter EcoBoost, we have ethanol fueling, or E85. So ethanol fueling has a lot of benefits and it can really offer incredible performance and power gains. However, it is very demanding on the fueling system, and that is one minor downside to the 3.0 EcoBoost. It did not receive the direct and port injection like the 2.7 and 3.5 EcoBoost engines did. So that holds it back a little bit from a fueling perspective and how much E85 you can safely run on the stock fuel system. But ultimately, you should be able to run roughly an E30 blend. Now, this will require proper tuning to adjust for ethanol and the more demanding fuel flow that it requires. But ultimately, even just with the small E30 blend, you can see power gains of about 10 to 20 wheel horsepower. So for nothing more than finding some E85 at a gas pump and mixing a little bit into your tank, really incredible performance gains and something that doesn't cost anything apart from getting that tune to account for and compensate for that ethanol fueling. Anyway, guys, that wraps up the five mods to build a 450 plus wheel horsepower 3.0 EcoBoost. So again, that's really all it takes is going to be a tune, intake, downpipes, intercooler, and potentially a small ethanol blend to give you that little extra bump in power and performance. With all of these mods, the 3.0 EcoBoost should end up somewhere in the ballpark of about 425 to 475 wheel horsepower and 500 plus wheel torque. So very incredible numbers for the twin turbo 3-liter EcoBoost engine. Again, the only downside to this engine right now when it comes to tuning and modifications is that it is still in the early stages of a lot of this tuning and development. So it can be a little bit harder and a little more time consuming to actually find the information and find the products available. But otherwise, this is an incredible engine that can make some serious power and torque with just a few basic bolt-ons and tuning. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.